defended began to suffer more and more losses, until their eventual and unconditional surrender in 1945. According to family accounts, Saburo, gripped by despair and shame, had resolved to commit seppuku, but then changed his mind at the very last moment. Why? No one knows. From the day he nearly took his own life, Saburo Arasaka has refused to speak about his wartime experience with anyone. He devoted his complete attention to one thing alone, his work. Following the death of his father, Sasai Arasaka, in 1960, Saburo assumed control of the family business. Under his direction, their humble company began on its path to becoming a world-leading corporate giant. It was in 1990 when Arasaka Corp. first emerged on the Global 500 list. Then in 1996, after the collapse of the United States, it rose to number 2 in the rankings. At the most trying time in our history, Saburo Arasaka provided thousands of Americans with reliable work and helped us regain a sense of our former prosperity. For that, we will always owe him a debt of gratitude. Arigato gozaimasu, Saburo-san.
He waiting.
WMS, N54, even the pirate networks. You blown up everywhere. And the Jaxter, he out in the car?
Yeah, he's there. Dead.
Condolences, friend. And the relic.
Got it right here.
I was afraid of that.
What?
Saburo Arasaka. Dead. You got any notion of the shit you pulled me into? You off the fucking Emperor! His Majesty! Anyone with so much as a pinky toe dipped in this mess is as good as dead!
You're the one who got us into this mess! Let's start with your prep work! You had no idea Saburo Arasaka'd be at the hotel?
I don't have access to his personal fucking schedule. And besides, nobody asked you to kill the old man.
That wasn't us!
No shit! Tell that to the Sokka ninjas they send after you! Alright, settle down. Gotta be tactical about this. Parker, Eddies, then we leave the city limits behind. But first, your face got blood all over it. Bathroom's there. Go get yourself cleaned up. Can't risk it, V. Remember our first convo?
Dex! What the fuck?
Seems I've chosen the quiet life after all. No blaze of glory for me. Never been better.
Sure don't look it.
I can't let you on! Hey, hey, we're chill!
Of course you're high.
Tonight, I'm here to say goodbye to all of you.
Money's money, can't fuck around with it.
Speaking.
You're wasting your lives following us around like dogs.
But crawled up your ass.
Okay. I want it today. Great.
Johnny, wait up.
Don't do this. You could still change your mind.
Get over here, man. Fuck this band. Not your crowd, not your noise. Do your own thing.
Bastard. Gonna miss you something awful.
See you in the next life, friend.
Change my mind.
Silverhand.
Hey, Shaden.
Get us in the air. Here, put this on, and it stays on. Got it?
Make it rain.
payload on the elevator. Arm it. Let gravity do its thing. Explosion rocks the foundation. Tower crumbles. Chaos screaming. Roll credits.
Exit window's gonna be tight.
Jacking in. Is grass green? Do birds fly? Do cats eat bats? Do rats shit nap?
Mainframe's not your playground, Murphy. Come on! Evac announcement! Broadcast it across all frequencies and let's get moving!
Sheesh. Who wrote this manifesto?
Really need me to answer that question?
Jesus, Johnny. You've gone off the deep end. That's coming from a chair jock.
Come on!
Open fire!
Get ready! One way to go!
Hands down!
Hey! Leave a little for me!
Goddamn terrorist! Oh!
Ugh! Get back! Ah!
She sided with Nimble, she sided with Care, pursued it with Forbes and Hope.
Johnny, Halo.
Bushido 2, bomb's name is what?
Wrap it up! We got a Delta!
The Demolitron. We're good to blow.
Shaka Elite's incoming!
Get out of there,
run
Johnny.
For it!
Shoot the cable! Get the rotor spinning! We're on our way!
Not done yet. Still need to feed this to their subnet.
I fucking knew it! This was never about corporate colonialism. This was about your groupie output, wasn't it?
No, you wouldn't understand, Rogue.
Giving you 4 fucking minutes! Chopper's not gonna wait 1 sec longer!
Door lock breached. Arasaka sons of bitches incoming.
Loved you, Spider.
Whole world loves me.
Closing in on the access.
Slot in. Sweet icebreaker. Foreign, right? Just wonder if we know anyone who can switch the subnet protocol.
Hilarious. You gonna help or not?
Do spiders spin webs? It's time we caught some flies.
Thanks, Murph.
Now, just for good measure. Holy cyber cow. We're on TV. Take a look.
Turn now to Arasaka Tower. Its evacuation ongoing after an unidentified terrorist organization released a manifesto threatening violence. The terrorists stating their desire to, quote-unquote, topple a monument to corporate colonialism. Night City's mayor, Imbole Ebunike, has issued a statement declaring that he will bring the full force of the law to bear in response to any act of terrorism. Going now to our reporter on the scene at Arasaka Tower. Hopefully he can shed some light on the situation as events unfold.
All set. Now get out of there. They're moving up. Hit the roof quick.
Murphy!
Door's sealed, but it won't hold for long. Run, Johnny. Like the wind.
Smasher.
Told you, Johnny boy. Told you I'd end you someday.
まだ生きています。わかりました、向かいます。
Let us try once more. Your associates. Who are they? How did you acquire fissile material?
Give good cop over there a chance to say something? Come on.
Which terrorist organization do you belong to? How did you acquire fissile material?
Boss don't look too pleased with your efforts.
Let's see.直接話をする。
Hot damn. Done and gone.
My husband died in that tower. But there are fates worse than death.
なぜこのようなことを?
Why did you do this?
To bring an end to the madness you wreak.
人は嘘をつき、自分自身を欺く。だが者は違う。者は雄弁だが、彼らは決して嘘をつかない。死者の言葉にはつつましさがある。始めろ。
And you, who are you? Heavier than she looks. Now, listen, dog. I have done exactly what you asked. So let's you and me figure this out.
荒らさか様、お父様の殺害犯ですけました。この女で間違いありません。はい、1時間後には着くかと。クワイエット、ひどい匂いだ。
Again. Keep your eyes open. We both could use medical attention. Do you know a Reaper doc whom you can trust?
You were at Gompeki Plaza.
We must get to Reaper Doc. Quickly!
Did well back there.
Do not waste time.
Victor. We'll fix this up.
We have to get there somehow. Call someone. Anyone.
Why not just cut me loose? I'm dead weight to you.
Make the call.
All right.
Greetings. My scanner indicates you are outside the service area.
Just Come. Pick me up. Need to get to Misty's Esoterica. In front of Vix.
Of course. A vehicle is en route. It should arrive in less than 20 minutes.
What are you doing? Hey! The personal link is damaged.
Please proceed to insert the jack below the ear, though not too deep. There should be auxiliary neurosockets between her lymph nodes, beneath the SCM muscle.
If I hit the vein by mistake, she'll die.
Indeed, as she will if you do nothing.
I think I have the socket.
Now proceed to connect.
Let's get her inside.
I cannot hold it. I need to rest.
That your blood? Misty! Pressure's tanking.
It's neurogenic shock. She's dying.
Gotta cut my way through the occipital bone. No other way.
There is risk of...
I know what I'm doing.
How is she?
Slower on the mend than you, but looking better every day. V, you in there?
Ah, my head.
How you feeling?
Fuck. I don't know, Vic. My ears are ringing. And then I'm seeing shit.
These hallucinations. Describe them to me.
Blinding lights. It's loud. I'm on stage and almost can't breathe. I'm so damn full of hatred. And then I let it all out into a mic, and I realize it didn't help. I don't feel any better. And then, I promise not to laugh, I plant a bomb in Arasaka Tower.
Nothing there to laugh about.
Night City looked different, strange, and I hated it. Hated everybody, every inch. It was too real, even for a lucid dream.
You weren't dreaming, V. Those were memories. There's a personality construct on that shard. Dreams you had were from his past.
Saying I experienced another psyche's memories? How is that even possible?
You two are connected in a way I can't make head or tail of.
Two? Me and who, Vic? Who's the other?
Johnny Silverhand, a terrorist. Real talk of the town back in my day. Anyway, that's not what's important right now.
Think you can top the terrorist in my brain?
Biochip. It's basically a bomb. Fuse lit already. You don't have much time left. Much life. A few weeks, tops. Silverhand's construct is overriding your consciousness, gradually taking over your body until one day you'll just be gone. V, it's important you get all this.
Don't believe an ounce of the horseshit coming from your mouth. Know why? Because it doesn't make any goddamn sense. Whatever's happening to me, there's a logical explanation. Gotta be. You're the best of the best, Vic. Why can't you help me?
You want the long story or the short?
Don't omit a thing. Not one D.
Okay. There is a construct. A psyche on the chip. That of Johnny Silverhand. You jacked it in your chip slot. Nothing happened, right? Until you died.
Bullet in the head from Dexter Deshaun. How do you come back from something like that?
Low caliber. You lucked out. Not least thanks to another poor decision by Mr. Deshaun. The nanites off the chip started fixing the damage. Then they took your hand and coaxed you off the path toward the light.
People don't just die and then get up like nothing happened.
Used to be true. Now it's only if they don't have a classified piece of corpotech primed to resurrect them.
What about me? My psyche? I make it back from the other side and what? I'm supposed to pretend change is normal?
Ask the Arasaka engineers who built the thing. All I know is your mind's gonna go. And it won't be pretty. From the biochip's perspective, your brain cells are a tumor that needs to be scooped out, while your body's an empty shell to hold the construct.
So this fucking terrorist wants to wipe me and take my place, take my body.
It's not willful on his part, it's automatic, inevitable, and neither of you can stop it.
Can we just take the chip out or switch it off?
Either way is out of the question. You die immediately.
Fuck. I remember this thing, saw it on TV. Oh, what was this stupid slogan? Soul something.
Secure your soul.
That's it. It's just supposed to let you communicate with constructs.
Maybe, but this is a prototype by the look of things. Somehow made it out of Arasaka Labs.
Vic, you've always come through for me. If there's nothing you can do to help me, then what the hell do I do? Tell me, please. Vic.
I wish I knew, kid. Misty?
You're asking too much from an old-timer like Vic. Come on, V. Let's get you home.
And then he died. And I thought I was gonna die with him in my sleep.
Sleep's a small hint of death. The inevitable.
Can't actually tell if I'm awake now. I mean, I could be dead already, right?
Not something to focus on, V. Let it go. Here. Got some meds for you. Omega blockers. Taken regularly, they'll keep things from progressing too quickly. Also,
They should keep that guest of yours calm and quiet. Pseudo-endotrizines from me. Effect will be opposite. It'll speed things up. Free the demon, so to speak.
Giving me a pill to prod that son of a bitch so he can kill me faster?
Listen, you're likely to be fine for a while. But sometime down the road, it could turn into pure agony. I'm giving you options, honey.
The brain can be tricked. Plain old painkillers do that.
Your psyche's gonna die, V. You'll feel your old self slipping away. At some point, you won't recognize yourself. It'll be terrifying. It'll be painful. But it doesn't have to be.
The fuck I need pills for. How did you stick a gun in my mouth? Pull the trigger.
Well, that way you'd kill two souls. Is that what you want?
Gotta lie down.
Here. Got one more thing for you. Vic pulled this out of your skull. A lucky charm? Promise you'll try to get some sleep.
Didn't you hear? My condition's terminal. What good can this do?
Don't be silly. As long as you're alive, there's hope. And don't let anyone tell you otherwise.
Really think I can make it? Survive this?
Of course you can. I mean, you did already die and come back once, didn't you?
Missy, wait. About Jackie.
Yeah?
I'm so fucking sorry Jack's not here anymore.
Jackie was special. Really spiritually rich. He touched so many people with his love. Don't worry. You'll be around.
Sure you'll be all right?
I'll be fine. Life is so beautifully powerful. So much more powerful than death. But right now, you need rest. So sleep. Please sleep.
Gotta get out of here, understand? And I'll kill anyone who gets in my way, you included. Need a smoke. Where'd you stash yours?
Where did you even come from? How are we even talking?
How the fuck should I know? The fuck kind of droid toy are you supposed to be?
Fucking ghost off!
find a way. You hear me?
See you never, asshole.
Now like that. Stick some iron in your mouth and pull the trigger.
I can feel it.
Our minds touch on you.
I'm like mold on fruit, creeping into you. Nothing I can do about it. You hear me? I'd puke if I fucking could.
It's just a copy of the engram. I'm out there somewhere. Gotta be.
Leave me alone! Get out! Just get the fuck out!
Lead to the head, only thing that will fix this. Hear me, bitch. A bullet to the fucking brain!
Oh, fuck me.
Takemura here. We must meet. Come to Thomas Diner.
Why would I do that?
Because I am the one who saved your life.
Haven't managed to get my head straight yet. Not after everything that happened.
That will not happen anytime soon. And so what? If you intend to leave, you must re-enter the ring. The bell has already tolled. Thomas Diner, I am waiting.
Open up!
Barry! We know you're in there! We're here to help!
Don't got no fucking warrant!
Cut the bullshit! Just open up!
We came here as colleagues. Nothing else. Haven't heard from you in a while. We're worried.
No, and now leave me alone.
Congrats, Mendez. Way to be a prick.
Oh, what? So I'm the bad guy? I'm not the one who pulled up. Cold life.
Someone in this tower go cuckoo again?
This is a private matter, so just move along.
Wait, she might know Barry.
There anything I can do?
Maybe. You know Barry at all?
More or less. Struck up a convo once or twice.
He's a friend from the precinct. Left the force not long ago. He broke down after his best friend died. We're worried he'll do something stupid.
Relax, Patrol. Barry's got nerves of steel. He's just a spiteful old bastard.
Mendez! Could you check on him when he's chilled down?
I don't know. Sounds too personal for me. Not the best shoulder to cry on.
Think about it, okay? Barry's a good guy. And a good cop. He doesn't deserve to end up alone.
I'll consider it. Can't promise anything. Hey, Barry? Everything all right in there? I'm gonna take that as a yes.
Try again later.
Just trouble. Usual stuff.
In need of iron and lead, then, I take it?
Next time through. Working against the clock today.
Hello, I'm Arif Iqbal with WNS News. Today is a sad one in our city's history. Mayor Lucius Rhine has passed away. We learned of Mayor Rhine's death from his family. He died peacefully in his sleep. The exact cause of his death has not been released, but initial reports suggest coronary implant failure. The remainder of Mayor Rhine's term will be fulfilled by his deputy mayor and closest associate, Weldon Holt. Holt has also announced plans to run for mayor in the upcoming election.
Today, we all mourn the untimely loss of our mayor and dear friend, Lucius Rhine. But when we've dried our tears, we must look to the future. To the future Lucius envisioned for our fair city.
So,
I am hanging in there.
Colin, too. offer my condolences.
Hmm? Offer your condolences? Ay, Jesucristo, V. You lived under our roof. Have the decency not to treat me like some stranger you just met. I was going to call you. I prepared an ofrenda for Jaquito. We can't let him go without a proper goodbye. The ceremony will be at the Coyote Cojon. Many of his friends will be there.
Say no more, Mama Wells. I'll be there.
I did not doubt it for a second. Ahí te veo, V.
You do not look so bad. Then, in the car, I doubted you would survive.
Why'd you help me anyway?
I needed you to leave. That hasn't changed.
This about the biochip? That why I'm here?
I hear it's damaged beyond repair. Any attempt to extract it would be disastrous, fatal for you.
Vic likes to talk, I guess.
Not many could do what he did. You should be thankful.
What's it you actually want from me?
To begin, you must tell me where to find Evelyn Parker.
Evelyn? What's she to you?
She and Yorinobu Arasaka had intimate relations. She knows how to get to him.
Been thinking I ought to have a word with her myself. She promised to help me get rid of the chip.
I would not count on that. She's likely gone, very far away.
Just answered your own question about where Evelyn is. Long gone.
Why do you believe she could help you remove the chip? Does a corporation help her?
Got no clue. Evelyn was knowledgeable about the relic, had a large chunk of classified info. An enigma, to be sure, but she showed that slyness you get in corpo agents. You know the kind.
I too possess this slyness you speak of.
You got tossed out, lumped with the outcasts, easily. Or have you forgotten? Sorry, I couldn't be of any help. Don't have any time to lose.
Wait. I need you. Yorinobu Arasaka must answer for this crime of patricide.
Looking for justice? In Night City?
I seek revenge. Much more feasible here. I have allies prepared to bring Yorinobu to his knees. The only thing I need is proof.
And you think they'll trust the word of a merc?
I have nothing better now. Also, I know no one here. And I am a fugitive. I am hunted.
What if I say no?
Then I will tell you what rewards await if you help me.
So what, we stroll into Arasaka HQ and announce that Yorinobu's a kin killer? That he murdered Saburo?
We'll get the hearing before reasonable people in a neutral location. Certain procedures will be used to establish the truth.
A lie detector? Forget it.
In that case, another option. You are dying. You do not know how to save yourself. A chip, the relic, is a culprit. Technology made by Arasaka. Technology they alone know. This corporation can save you as easily as it can make you disappear. It is merely about getting the right people on your side. Politics.
Exactly what kind of people are we talking about?
People who hold Arasaka dear, its heart. people interested in the corporation's stable growth.
You mean people like Anders Hellman?
You know this name? How?
Prepped for the heist thoroughly. Relic is Hellman's design, his creation.
And true. He's a pawn. I was thinking of one much more powerful. Besides, Anders Hellman escaped Arasaka. Betrayed it.
Now, Hanako-sama, I would first like to ask you...
Fucking Sokka scums everywhere.
Hey, I was listening to that.
Shut up. Nobody except you wants to watch that shit about that corpo cunt.
What did you say?
You heard me.
Let it go, Takamura.
At least one of you's got some fucking sense.
Tom's all right. Not afraid to speak his mind, that's all.
He reminds me of my father. He also worked in a kitchen all his life.
Thanks for the offer. Need to think about it. Get back to you.
I need time to plan, organize. You stand to gain much if you help me. All I ask is that you do not leave the city.
Leave? Why would I leave? Need help. Best chance I'll find the right person here.
Someone other than Arasaka specialist? There's no one. No alternative.
Actually, we just talked about some. Anders Hellman. He invented the relic. If I want to get rid of it, he's my man. And if that means picking another fight with Arasaka, so be it.
Hellman defected from the company. I myself spent many days looking for him. He... What's the expression? Dropped off the face of the earth.
Somebody's been busy the last few days.
I will not sit and do nothing when there is information to be found. Things to prepare.
Your job, basically.
It was my job.
Why are you looking for Hellman?
He was the one to alert Saburo-san to Yorinobu's schemes. He knew both of them well and could be an important witness.
Corporal rats squeal when hanging by their tails.
For several days, I collected the information. All leads point to one place, the club called the Afterlife. I was quickly dismissed by the Queen of Fixers there, Rogue.
Mean to say you worked for Saburo, yet got no idea how to talk to the High and Mighty.
She wished to have nothing to do with the man accused of murdering Saburo Arasaka.
Rogue's well informed. Gets wind of most things that happen in the city. Might be worth asking her about Hellman.
I wish you luck. The old man is choosy, expensive, and rude.
Anders Hellman. He invented the relic. If I want to get rid of it, he's my... Corporal. Rogue's one. With a bit of luck, I'll track down Evelyn.
If she could not help you before, she will not manage to now.
Honor among thieves. Ever heard of it?
Yes. I thought it ironic. Thieves have none. There's just honor, I believe.
Yorinobu Arasaka degree? I'm sure.
That Parker woman will not help you. Why are you? I would think about a plan B. I cannot stay here any longer. Do what you want. Look for Parker, Hellman, whoever. I must see some friends. call in some favors. When my people in Arasaka are ready to listen, I will call you.
Till then, I guess.
If by some miracle you find Hellman, please notify me. He and I have unfinished business.
Zapper dumples and filth. In some ways, Night City never changes. Arasaka's still a despotic machine, and the world's on a collision course with chaos. But hey, at least Rogue's still alive.
You know, you've got some nerve. First you're out to kill me, now you want to be my pal and make like nothing happened?
You know you don't gotta speak out loud to talk to me.
What do you want?
And I've processed some shit, changed my mind. Don't want you dead anymore.
Go fuck yourself, dickwipe.
Hey, wasn't easy for me either. You woke up in a landfill, I woke up in your head. Wrestling with your thoughts, memories. Think we're even. And I've taken a step back, looked at things. Think we might be able to help each other. We could start with Rogue. Her and I go back to the Stone Age.
Why should I trust you? Remind me again?
Trust me, don't trust me. I don't give a fuck. It's the least of our worries, anyway.
You are the ghost of Christmas past, asshole. Any friends you've had are either dead or so old their memory's gone.
Johnny Silverhand died a legend. Nobody forgets that.
So you fucking know Rogue. What would I say to her? I got a talking brain tumor, claims it's her old friend Johnny?
Trust me, Rogue's heard dumber shit than that. Way back when you weren't even an itch in your daddy's ballsack.
Don't need convincing. Seen your memories. Gross.
Rogue will dance to any tune I play, or just get us to the afterlife.
There is no us. Bukako Okada, the Lady of Westbrook Estate.
When you find a moment, come see me. We must settle our accounts for Sandra Dorset. You did quite well. You and that friend of yours. Until then.
Introductions necessary. Already took care of them.
Someone comes to me with beers, I take care of it. I eat, sleep, and breathe. Remember that.
Aye, aye, Captain.
While we're at it, need fresh wheels, bikes. I got it all. Real good prices. So hit me up anytime, you hear?
Heard you're home.
Already? Sure got that ear to the ground.
Siempre. Anyway, you need something. You know where to find me.
Table, we got to get rid of it.
Really? It's pretty massive.
So?
Maybe we scooch it, put it up against the wall.
V, nice to see you. Oye, sit. Sit. You want a beer?
Wouldn't mind one.
Salud. A lot of time has passed. How you been?
Been better, to tell you the truth.
What is happening?
That night when Jackie fell, let's just say, things haven't exactly been easy since.
Yo sé cómo te sientes. Todos lo sabemos. I am in the middle of preparing an ofrenda. There is still so much to take care of.
Could help you with that?
Gracias, mi cielo. But I will manage. It's enough you come to say goodbye.
Want to take part in the ceremony, but want to do it the right way, in line with tradition.
Mm-hmm.
But something I'd lay by his casket that'd do justice to his memory, I don't got anything.
But your heart, it's in the right place, mi niña. Don't worry. He's symbolic. Look for something in his garage. His past is all there.
Jackie had a garage?
He used it for his motorcycle, mostly. But not so long ago, he moved in. You'll find something there, I'm sure.
Won't mind me digging through his stuff?
No, mija. He's gone, and funerals are for the living, not the dead. Toma, take the key.
Thanks, Mama Wells.
Don't mention it, V. You have respect. I admire that. The garage is on Republic. Ahí te veo.
Thank you.
Hi, V.
You here alone? This is not exactly the safest neighborhood in town, Misty.
I used to sit on the stairs when I was 10. 26 now. If anything was gonna happen, it wouldn't have taken this long.
What are you doing here?
Sitting and waiting. And yeah, waiting for him. Though I know he's never coming back. Lately, I've just been coming here to sit. An hour. Sometimes two. I know it's gonk, it's just... I miss him. A lot. Wanna sit? Catch up?
Hardly gonk at all. Just... well, human.
I guess.
You know each other long?
Half our lives. Grew up in the same streets. Saw each other a lot, but just never got together.
Till you're back.
Yeah. Best darn year of my life.
Jack talked about you a lot. Always saying how much you meant to him.
Did he really say that? I bet he used different words.
Maybe, but that's what he meant. I really believe that.
You actually got to know him. The real Jackie. Everybody else thought he was a goofball with a rough-hewn face and an edge. But they're wrong.
Nah, Jack was a little of that, too. Always looking on the bright side.
He wore his heart on his sleeve. And wasn't at all afraid to live fully. Had his inner demons, though.
Who doesn't?
Exactly. They're what makes us who we really are on the inside. There's a huge chunk of his past in there.
How come you're outside?
I don't have the key.
Jackie never gave you a set? You two didn't get that far.
He offered, but I wanted him to have his own space. Just his own.
Mama Wells is having a send-off for Jackie. I need to find something he really cared about. Mind giving me a hand?
I'm not sure I should go in there, V.
Still too soon.
No, it's not that. Mama Wells and I aren't exactly on the best terms. She wouldn't want me touching any of his things, disturbing the memory. That I know.
Jackie'd want you here. That's more important. Come on. Jackie loved to pump iron, didn't he?
He called it his form of meditation. He used to say, barbells are the best listeners. They understand all your problems and never give you gonk advice.
Gotta be hanging here since 2020. Fine piece of metal and mechanics. He was so psyched. Loved to poke around engines.
He was 15 when he first got on a bike.
Knowing him, it is a miracle he never wiped out. Guess no man cave's complete without some of those, huh?
He said they're collectibles. They don't print them anymore.
It's definitely why they're up there, yeah. For whom the bell tolls. Ernest Hemingway.
Jack read it a dozen times. Always right before a big job. He said the guy who wrote it was tougher than Morgan Blackhand.
You read it? Is it any good?
I never got the chance.
It'd be a good tribute for the Ofrenda, though. Still full.
His favorite. Strategic reserve. No touching.
How come?
¿Por qué no puedes tocar una reserva estratégica, va?
Jack. Pure and simple.
Well, you got something for your ofrenda. But we could look around a little more.
Basketball signed by Dante Gonzalez.
He was from Haywood, too. Everyone here shot hoops. Dante ran circles around him. I think he might have been the first kid to ditch the Valentinos.
Like Jackie?
Mm-hmm. They both wanted more out of life. Dante's captain of the NC Blackouts now.
This'll be fitting.
Oh, Jackie.
That a mandala?
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a long story.
Hey, you all right?
I'm so much better than all right. I once told Jackie he should sweep all the dark energy out of this place. A sand mandala would do the trick, for example. He told me that out of sand he'd build a castle, a home, the Wells family hideout, stronghold, something.
I guess you made a bigger impression than you thought.
I guess I did.
Isn't it just a little janky?
It's hideous. But it's also the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
An aquarium?
It used to be tacos.
And Taco was...
Miss Fish. A dwarf shark. Like, Minnie.
Sounds like a mighty expensive fish.
Oh, I don't think he bought it.
Jackie's favorite tequila. Still sealed.
It's his lucky charm. One of the first bottles ever made by Jesus de Abajo.
The founder of Sensan Tequila.
Only 100 of them left in the world. All owned by the 1%.
How did Jackie get this one?
Some shriveled abuela in Mexico sold it to him. Told him De Abajo had stolen her recipe.
Taking this, yeah. Perfect for Jackie. Leather belt?
Sort of a memento. His dad's. He used to beat both Jackie and his mom with it. Until one day, Jackie fought back. Kicked his butt. Told him he'd kill him next time. Old man was hospitalized, and then he left.
Why did he hold on to it?
In case his dad ever comes back.
Gotta be Jackie's dad.
Old school ganger. Valentinos, of course.
Did you meet him?
No, I only ever heard about him. But he didn't exactly inspire many fond memories.
Nice still. Where are you going?
Actually, V, I think I'll stay a while. Say bye to him here. Mama Wells wouldn't want me there anyway.
What happened between you two? What's the beef?
Let's just say she didn't see me as daughter-in-law material.
What did she have against you?
That my name wasn't Camila and I wasn't Jackie's ex-output. Camila was Mama Wells' favorite.
Right. You gotta come, Misty. Got a right to be there.
I'd rather not get in Mama Wells' way. It's for family.
You were family to him.
I guess you're right. Thanks, V. So, shall we go?
You ever thought you might leave Night City?
Sure. Once upon a time, I even tried.
Seriously? Meaning?
Packed my bags and hopped on a plane to Nepal. Thought I'd stay there. After a week, I realized I couldn't live without the traffic outside my window and my neighbors hollering.
Go raise a glass to him, padre. A few glasses.
De acuerdo.
V, it's good you're here. We're about to start. Sit down, please.
Hey, V.
I thank you all for coming today. I'm not going to tell you what kind of man my son was, or lament about how much I miss him. Instead, I'll tell you a story. When he was about 19 years old, Jackie was in the Valentinos. They were at war with Maelstrom back then. I get a call from the hospital. They tell me he got shot. 3 times, just by the heart. He was conscious when I get there. So many tubes coming out of him. He looked like a pulpo, like an octopus or something. He tell me, he said, "No te preocupes, mama. Look, I'm bulletproof. Nothing bad'll ever happen to me. And when I go, he take off his Valentino's ring. He swear he won't need it anymore. But he was not scared. He just didn't want me to worry. Descansa en paz, mi hijo."
Among the membership of the Night City Devils Boxing Club, we had this saying: make your best friends among the fighters who knock you out cold. And it's true. Jackie's arm was a cannon. No one's ever hit me as hard. I can still almost feel it. Twelve rounds, buddy.
Me mandó Camporta. Lamenta no estar aquí. Todavía le quedan 4 años que cumplir. Me pidió que leyera esto. Recuerdo cuando Jackie se nos unió. Era un niño fuerte. Cuando decía que iba a hacer algo, cumplía. Tenía honor. Podría haber llegado lejos. Mis condolencias a la familia. Que descanse en paz.
Anyone else?
I often think back to the first time me and Jack met. It all started when he put a heater to my head.
Then some badges showed up. Beat the shit out of both of us. Half my fault, half his. We hightailed it out together. Half an hour later, we were eating dinner at Mama Wells's. Turned out to have more in common than we thought. Principals. Jackie Wells. The best friend you could ask for. Loyal to a fault. Once he set his mind on something, he was ready to die to achieve it. He once told me, "Chica, the one thing we can't do is be afraid of others." He kept Haywood in his heart, always. It made him who he was. But most importantly, everyone saw Jackie as a grinning charmer who saw the good in everyone, everything. They were wrong. Jackie Wells was a hell of an ambitious chum who never gave up and whose drive cost him his life. But he did in life what he said he'd do. Reached for fortune and fame. No fear in his eyes or heart. When you go to war as a boy, you have a great illusion of immortality. Other people get killed, not you. Then, when you are badly wounded the first time, you lose that illusion. Rest easy, Chum.
I would like to say a toast. Por mi hijo. Thank you for your kind words, V. I'm glad you're here. It was a beautiful ofrenda we gave him. A lot of people come today. Even that putica Jackie was messing around with.
Her name is Misty.
What?
Misty. She was very important to him. Do you understand? Go. Invite her along for dinner. It's the least she deserves.
Do you know what? You're a good woman. Jackie would want you to have these.
Are you sure? Jackie'd kill me if I got so much as a scratch on it.
So don't get any scratches on it.
Thank you. I'll take such good care of it.
Cuídate, V.
Campos all torn up. Says he feels like he lost one of his own.
I wonder if he'll be as torn up after you die.
Sucks to meet like this.
Don't go starting something, eh?
Not farewells today. Aren't that bad once you get used to them.
Have you gotten used to them?
When you get to my age, friends don't come and go. They just mostly go.
Jackie Wells.
A proud son of Haywood.
I should mingle, Vic.
Sure. See you later, V.
Hey. You all right?
Yeah. I think I'm just still in that garage, mentally. I just need a sec. It's so, so good. To see you.
Lupe's been handling their loss pretty good.
She's a strong woman.
here to say goodbye to one of your own, Padre?
I'm here to say goodbye to a good man.
Jackie, did you know him well?
I remember the day his mother brought him into this world. The day his father left. The day he took you into his home. Yes, V. I knew him quite well.
So, Padre, you think Jackie's looking down upon us from up there?
I believe he has met God, stood before him.
That's it?
I don't know if God left the meeting happy, but I'm pretty certain Jackie did.
I'm gonna move on.
Go with God.
Poured you another? For Jaquito?
Weird, being here without Jackie.
Can't shake the feeling I'm gonna turn around and see him sitting at the bar. In his favorite spot, where he always used to sit.
See, the Valentinos haven't forgotten about Jackie.
Days like this, even the meanest motherfuckers pay their respects. Principles. Jackie lived by them. They's what get them going.
Poor. For Jackie.
Amen, sister.
Hey, you!
Have a drink with us, To Wells?
Think we might know each other.
Gustavo Horta.
V.
Yeah, I've heard about you. Well, heartfelt condolences, friend. From me, Campo, and all the Valentinos.
Thank you. How'd you meet Jackie?
We started out together.
In the Valentinos?
No, in the fucking Bible Book Club. Yeah, I got only good memories of him. Rest easy up there, brother.
All right, why not?
To Wells. May he rest in peace.
Good for now, thanks.
See? You gotta know when to stop.
Aye, give me a break. All right, let's go.